In the stillness of the countryside, far removed from the bustle of city life, a man seeks refuge. This man, John Hartley, is a beekeeper, an unlikely figure to those who might have known him in a previous life, but to the bees, he is their protector. His hives hum with the rhythmic pulse of nature, thriving amidst fields of wildflowers. For John, tending to his bees is more than a job. It is a meditation, a lifeline tethering him to the simplicity of existence, a world where life, death, and rebirth follow a predictable cycle. The bees, for all their fragility, hold a wisdom far older than mankind. And it is this ancient rhythm, this connection to life's most delicate balance, that gives John the peace he so desperately craves. Yet beneath the surface of this peaceful landscape, there is a history John wishes he could forget. For years he tried to outrun it, but as is often the case, the past has a way of catching up with those who run too far. John wasn't always a beekeeper. In a previous life, he was something far more dangerous, a tool in the hands of governments, a weapon wielded in the shadows, and a man whose skills in covert operations were unmatched. But that life came at a cost, one that weighed heavily on his soul, leaving scars deeper than any battle wound. The tranquility of John's current existence belies the storm within. The buzzing of the bees is a comfort now, a reminder of nature's order. But there was a time when the sound of chaos was his companion. He once moved through war zones and battlefields with the same precision he now uses to tend his hives. Back then, his life was governed by missions, high-stakes operations in foreign lands, where failure wasn't an option and the stakes were measured not in honey but in blood. Years ago, in the prime of his service, John led teams into places most wouldn't dare step foot. His mind was sharp, his body finely tuned, and his heart hardened against the violence around him. But as the years wore on, the weight of those missions began to chip away at his resolve. The faces of those he'd lost, both friends and enemies alike, began to haunt him. He started to question the purpose of his work, wondering if the sacrifice was worth the cost. When one mission went horribly wrong, resulting in the loss of innocent lives, something in John broke. He walked away from it all, turning his back on the violence, the chaos, and the world of covert warfare. Now, in the solitude of the countryside, John has found something resembling peace. The bees, with their diligent work and intricate social structures, represent everything he once craved: order, purpose, and harmony. Each day he rises with the sun, tending to the hives, ensuring the bees have what they need to thrive. It's a simple life, but one that allows John to forget, even if just for a while, the man he used to be. Yet deep down, he knows that peace is fragile, just like the balance within the hive. And like the bees, who can turn aggressive if threatened, John too harbors a darkness within, one that he has fought hard to keep buried. But peace, like all things, is temporary. On an ordinary afternoon, the stillness of John's life is shattered. It begins with a black SUV that pulls up to his farm, the quiet hum of the engine at odds with the natural sounds of the countryside. Three men step out, dressed in suits that are out of place in this rural setting. They are led by a figure John recognizes instantly: Hayden King, a government agent he thought he'd never see again. Hayden's presence is a harbinger of trouble. As he approaches, there is no greeting, no pleasantries exchanged. Hayden gets straight to the point. They need John's help. There is a situation, one that requires his unique set of skills. John's first instinct is to refuse. He's done with that life, or at least he thought he was. But the look in Hayden's eyes tells him that this isn't a request. It's a summons. John turns away, walking back to his farmhouse, but the weight of the conversation lingers. The world he left behind has found him once more, and no amount of distance will keep it at bay. The next morning, as John makes his way to the hives, he's met with a sight that stops him cold. His bees are gone. The hives are destroyed, as if they've been ripped apart. The once thriving colonies, his sanctuary, have been reduced to ruins. It is an act of violence, a deliberate attack, and John knows immediately that this isn't random. When he confronts Hayden, the agent is unapologetic. It wasn't them, he claims, but someone else. Someone far more dangerous. The words hit John like a punch to the gut. Whoever did this knew exactly what they were doing. They knew that the bees were John's life, his reason for staying away from the darkness. And now, they're using that knowledge to pull him back into a world he swore he'd never return to. As Hayden explains the situation, John listens with a growing sense of dread. A bioterrorist group has emerged, using a new, insidious weapon, weaponized bees. They've managed to engineer a toxin, carried by the bees, that can kill in seconds. It's a threat unlike anything the world has ever seen, and only someone with John's expertise in both combat and beekeeping can track down and neutralize this new danger. Reluctantly, John agrees to take on the mission. He knows he has no choice. The destruction of his hives was a message, a declaration of war. And though he hates what it means, he also knows that the only way to stop the threat is to face it head on. With his old military skills awakened, John sets out on a journey that will take him deep into the underbelly of a world he thought he'd left behind. The bees, once symbols of life and tranquility, have now become tools of death. As John moves through the shadows, tracking the terrorist organization, he is forced to confront the darkest parts of himself. Each encounter brings him closer to the truth, but it also brings him closer to the man he used to be. a man who was willing to do whatever it took to get the job done, no matter the cost. In the heat of battle, John's instincts take over. He fights with the same precision he once used to tend his hives, using everything at his disposal, including his knowledge of bees. In one tense moment, he sets fire to a hive, using the smoke to disorient his enemies and buy himself precious time. In another, he uses the bees themselves, directing them toward a group of armed guards, forcing them to retreat. But as the mission drags on, John begins to question if he's truly doing the right thing. The line between good and evil blurs, and he starts to wonder if he's simply trading one form of violence for another. The faces of those he's lost, both in the past and present, haunt him once more. It is in these moments of doubt that John reaches out to Rebecca, an old friend from his military days who now runs a bee sanctuary. She is the one person who understands his struggle, the only one who knows the full weight of his past. Rebecca listens as John pours out his doubts, his fears. She reminds him of something he once told her, that sometimes you have to fight to protect what matters. It's a truth John has tried to forget. But now, in the midst of this new battle, he realizes that it's the only thing keeping him going. He isn't fighting for himself, he's fighting for the bees, for the world they represent, and for the chance at a life free from the violence that has defined him for so long. In the final showdown, John faces Dr. Marcus Lane, the mastermind behind the terrorist organization. Lane is a man who sees himself as above nature, a puppet master pulling the strings of life and death. As Lane unleashes his weaponized bees, John must use every ounce of his knowledge to outsmart him. The bees, once his allies, are now his enemies, and the battle becomes a race against time. But in the end, it is nature itself that proves to be Lane's downfall. John manages to redirect the swarm back onto Lane, using the very weapon Lane created against him. As the bees turn on their master, John watches as the man's grand plans unravel. With the mission complete, John returns to his farm, to the ruins of his hives. He begins the process of rebuilding, not just the hives, but himself. The bees will return, he knows, just as they always have. And with them, perhaps, so will the peace he so desperately seeks. As the sun begins to set, casting a golden hue across the fields, John stands before his hives. The damage inflicted on them is a reflection of the turmoil that has raged within him. But just as bees can rebuild their colonies, so too must John rebuild his life, piece by piece. It is a slow, deliberate process, much like the way the bees gather nectar, one flower at a time. The destruction of the hives was meant to break him, to tear him away from the quiet life he had built. Yet, standing here now, John realizes that the bees, with their resilience and determination, have taught him something deeper. They've shown him that no matter how fragile life may seem, it always finds a way to continue. He watches as a few surviving bees begin to return, tentatively exploring the remnants of their former home. It is a small but significant sign, a symbol of hope. Just as they are starting over, so must he. In their survival, John sees a reflection of his own journey. He may have been pulled back into the world of violence, but he is determined not to let it consume him. This time, he will rebuild not as the man he once was, but as the man he has become, a protector of life, not a taker of it. The mission has left scars, both physical and emotional, but John knows that healing is a process. The bees heal their hive with wax and time, and so too will he heal himself with patience and purpose. He cannot change the past, nor can he undo the choices that led him to this point. But he can choose what comes next. He can choose to move forward, to live in harmony with the world around him, just as the bees do. As the last rays of sunlight fade from the sky, John walks away from the hives, his heart lighter than it has been in years. The buzzing of the bees fades into the background, a comforting sound that reminds him that life, in all its complexity, endures. He is no longer just a beekeeper, nor is he the hardened soldier he once was. He is something in between. A man who has faced the darkness within and come out the other side, scarred but stronger. Tomorrow the bees will return in greater numbers, and John will be ready for them. He will rebuild their home, just as he will rebuild his own. And as the cycle of nature continues, so too will John's journey, a journey of redemption, of healing, and of hope. For in the bees he has found more than just solace. He has found a mirror to his own soul, a reflection of the resilience that exists within all living things. And so, the beekeeper stands tall, knowing that no matter what the future holds, he has the strength to face it.